In this video, we will see how to grow this Indian sorrel in our containers. So this is commonly known by different names like common sorrel, garden sorrel, and in Telugu you call this as chukakura, and in Kannada chukke soppu, and in Hindi as katapalak, because the leaves are little tangy in nature. So you call with you have lots of names for this leafy vegetable. So we will see how to grow this plant today. Apart from this, I have already sown these seeds in a container and I have taken updates of the plant. I will show you the updates of that plant as well today, from germination to harvest. So let's get started. Hi, this is Aparna. Welcome to Aparna's Green Garden. For growing this green leafy vegetable, I am taking here a container of 6-inch depth. So that is enough for this leafy vegetable. In case you have larger depth containers also, it's okay, you can use them still. Here I will show you how to sow these seeds. Here if you see, these are the seeds of sorrel plant. If you see, this is how you would have received in the package. See, there is a coating around the seed here. This is the flower and this is the coating. If you see, when I am just popping it open, you can see that there is a seed inside which is very small. So if you are planting straight away with this, see, these are the seeds. In case you want to plant the seed with the seed coat, in case you want to sow this seed coat with this seed coat, maybe the germination time might be little longer. But whereas when you directly sow these seeds, yeah, it will germinate between somewhere between 4 to 7 days. For me, it has germinated by end of 5th day. In case you are sowing the seed with along with that coat there, it will take definitely 1 week to 10 days, somewhere in between that. So now I'll show you the sowing method. So when you are sowing here, see, I'm just making some lines here with a, you know, the difference between these two lines is somewhere around 1.5 inch. You can maintain it, and you can sow one or two seeds in each thing row. I have with a distance between them of 1 inch. I'm just sowing like this, at least one or two. If you put in this soil, at least one might germinate. After this, I will not give too much of you know, coverage over the seeds, because these are very small. Maybe if you put too much of soil on it, it might not even germinate. So I am just putting like this the soil, closing it with little amount of soil and just gently tapping it, because when we are watering, I just don't want the seeds to be disturbed. So after sowing these seeds, the rest portion I will complete it later. After sowing this, now coming to the watering requirements, how should you water this green leafy vegetable? As you know, for rest, like how we do it for rest of the green leafy vegetables, this doesn't require too much of watering. With minimum amount of watering, this will really do good. So I just water the plant and just maintain the moisture in the soil. And when I water the plant, I water it thoroughly. And the next watering would be when you know, the 1 inch layer goes little dry. That is when I water usually this plant. Next, coming to the sunlight requirements, this requires a good amount of sunlight. It requires tentatively 6 hours of sunlight in a day. So put it in a spot where it receives bright sunlight. In case you are living in apartments and you don't get a good amount of sunlight, keep it in a spot at least where it receives at least 4 hours of sunlight. So keep it in that kind of spot. Next, coming to the pests and its management. So far when I have grown this sorrel plant, I have not noticed any pest attack on my plants, but usually the common problems would be aphids, mealybugs, and this leaf suckers. That is, they will be in green in color. They will blend along with the leaf surroundings, and they will be eating away the leaves. They will be sucking the entire leaves out of it. Yeah, I have something here, something like this. It will start making making holes in the leaves like this. So something like this. So if we identify the problem in the initial stages, yeah, for this cauliflower plant, it had I had some issues wherein I couldn't deal right away with this, and when I checked out and gave remedy for this, it was little too late. and the you know the leaf had been eaten away by the you know the caterpillars like things. Happily they have eaten away those leaves. So before it is too late, when you notice that the leaves are being eaten away by the worms, immediately apply the neem oil. And with the neem oil has to be taken around 3 to 4 ml per liter of water, and mix it with soap solution and spray on the leaves. But after you spray on the leaves, be sure not to harvest it right away. Harvest it only at least minimum after 10 days or 15 days for consumption purposes. So that is with respect to pest and its management. Next is we will see how we are doing the harvesting, and the updates also we will see right now. So how do you know the plant is ready to harvest? So if you see, the plant is ready to harvest when you notice the leaves are little tender and they have grown to considerable height. That is when you can harvest the plant. So this is with respect to harvesting. Cut. Now, after we have harvested this plant, next section would be your fertilizers and manure. So how often should we fertilize this plant or add manures? So when I am usually what I do is, once I have harvested my leaves, that is when usually I apply manure, because initially when we have mixed the potting soil, we have already added compost, good amount of compost into the soil. So after my initial harvest, that is usually harvest, we usually harvest these leaves somewhere between 30 days or 40 days. So once I harvest my these leaves, that is when usually I do my composting. I add my vermicompost or some organic compost. So I am just adding generous amount of you know this vermicompost here. I have vermicompost. Usually I have already shown you the composting process. So I take the compost and I add it to my, you know, this plant here like this. So what can we do in between period? That is, now if you are harvesting after 30 days or 40 days, say, what do you do in between? So germination stage would be completed somewhere between 1 week to 10 days. So after that, in this 20 days, what do we do? So usually what I'd add is, I spray these liquid fertilizers which we have talked earlier also, like say onion peel fertilizers or banana peel fertilizers or this cow dung liquid fertilizers. All these things can be sprayed on this every 1 week or 10 days. So usually I follow a routine of 10 days. So then I spray after 10 days, after germination, after 10 days I usually spray foliage spray. So two times I would be spraying in between, so that it will give me good harvest after, you know, 30 days or 40 days of time period. So now that we have seen seed sowing to harvest, it's very easy to grow this Indian sorrel. It's easy to maintain and it doesn't require too much of hard work from your end. So if you have any other doubts or clarifications, you can write down in our comments box below. Until the next video, stay safe, practice social distancing, and whenever you are stepping outside, wear mask. Until the next video, take care, bye.